Most definitely. There is a proven strong correlation between crime and inequality. In fact, it is especially a strong correlation between crime and visible inequality. While it may seem obvious, the mechanisms are not obvious in all manners. Many people easily jump to the conclusion that the crime caused by inequality is due to simply envy. However, it is more complex than that. Adam Smith, many regarded as sort of the philosophical father of capitalism, wrote in his famous book, The Wealth of Nations, in 1776 about how poverty is a relative concept. As he observed, society sets a standard of expectation of material wealth. When you cannot meet this lowest standard, you feel a shame, and this shame is what constitutes poverty. Adam Smith gave some examples. E.g., he remarked that walking barefoot was quite socially acceptable in France, while in Britain only the most beggarly person walked without shoes. Hence, not having shoes would bring about a shame and low self-esteem in Britain but not in France. Thus, as a society gets more affluent and what becomes the expected norm changes. Hence, what constitutes poverty changes. A man would go at great lengths to avoid feeling ashamed. If somebody has to walk on the street ashamed of the clothes they have to wear or ashamed of perhaps the clothes or conditions their children live under, they may go great lengths avoiding that, including committing crimes. The other problem is that getting, say, a meaningful job and thus feel purpose in life is more difficult in more developed countries. You need good education. But if society is highly unequal, you will not get it. In less developed countries, there would be plenty of jobs an unskilled person could do, which could give that person a sense of purpose and value. In a developed country, a poorly educated person will often be outcompeted by a machine automating almost any task a poorly skilled person could do. Thus, there are many ways in which inequality helps destroy a person's sense of self-worth and purpose, and thus lead many down a toxic path. Crime rates would decrease if police would stop charging people with victimless crimes. No victim, no crime. It would bring integrity to policing. This would bring back trust and support from the people. Victimless crime should be a crime. Economic opportunity and fair, proper compensation, what gives people motivation to do better. The kind of economic inequality we are experiencing now is because we do not live in a country where all men are created equal. There are no consequences for a certain subset of society for any wrongdoings. Until everyone has the same opportunity to earn a living, and until the rich and the corrupt have to follow the same rules as the rest of us and suffer consequences when there are victims resulting from their crimes, it is impossible for our world to live in harmony. The power does not belong in the hands of those who make the most money to buy their way out of having to participate fairly in an equal society. There should not be a ruling class. We need leaders, not rulers. That will lower crime rates. We give our power away when we rely on a government to solve our problems. Money isn't the root of all our problems. It is the power we give away by allowing government to declare it is in charge of anything other than protecting its citizens. We need more individual accountability and less government. This is an interesting question. You need to look at different countries' approach to equity. In some communist or formerly communist countries, they espouse the belief that everything should be shared equally, yet in practice the men in power in those countries have somehow skimmed enormous riches off the top for themselves and their families. Harsh punishments for misdemeanors can terrify people into compliance with laws. But those countries may also arrest political opponents on invented charges. So the country may be relatively free of crime, except for corruption. In another example, a European democracy may also have corruption. For instance, what if I tell you I will cut your tax bill in half? All you have to do is offer me a little tip or bribe. Everyone is happy with this system, until the country goes bankrupt from not collecting enough taxes and can no longer provide services or pay its bills. The problem with capitalism is that the rich keep getting richer and the poor keep getting poorer. Then the rich people either are in power themselves or pay to put people in power who will maintain the system favorable to them. For the present, it seems like surveys are showing that happiest people live in countries with such high minimum wages and high taxes on rich people that almost everyone they see when they look around has a similar lifestyle to themselves. These countries also have low crime rates. It makes people unhappy to work hard and yet be unable to afford basic needs like housing, food, childcare, transportation and healthcare. Very few of these struggling people commit crimes, however. Unconscious bias toward residents of poor neighborhoods and the association of poverty with crime can have deadly consequences.